What's up, guys? John Cope here again from Cope Racing Transmissions. And we got a pretty cool project here in the shop. We got this late model Ram that came in for a transmission. And this truck had a 545 FRE in it. And we did a swap on it. Unlike the Frostbite truck, we did a 727 swap because all this customer does is use the truck for drag racing. So I wanted to show you how we did the swap and how the swap looks. The first part I'll give you here is the B&M shifter. As you can see, there's no carpeting in there. It's got a removable steering wheel. It's a pretty lightweight truck. We just use your standard B&M ratchet shifter for this instead of a PPP because it's kind of a little bit of a budget. Nice shifter, it works real good. And that's where we mounted it. We put it right there next to the driver's seat so you'll be able to get to it. I'll show you the motor. Got a carbon fiber hood. It's pretty neat. This air cleaner lid almost resembles the either the six pack or the 426 Hemi dual quad air cleaner setup. It's a 5.7, even though it says 392. I don't know much about the motor. It's got some pieces on it. It looks like it's got nitrous. Improved oiling system. He's got an oil cooler, remote oil filters. It's got aftermarket headers. I'm thinking it's about 500, maybe 550 horsepower out of a 5.7. I think this may be for the purge system. Like I said, I don't know the cam. I do, but I don't. It's on the build sheet. And it's in my home. Yeah, we can see pretty good underneath there. Well, I'll start with the back. The drive shaft had to be lengthened. We use the same joints. We just got a longer tube because the 727 is shorter than the 545 and a 46. So we use the same yoke. The same drive shaft ends, we just got a new tube. The cross member and the transmission mount are factory and in the factory location. No modifications had to be done for this. We did make this bracket, as you can see, coming up and over and down to use the factory cross member and the factory transmission mount and bolted up to a 727. Those are the stud kits that we got, 2.58 studs. Is a reverse manual, no trans brake, 3-speed, no lockup, just a racing reverse manual valve body. He wanted to go foot braking. We put a billet drum in it. We put a 16 roller drag sprag in it. four pinion planetaries, and my reverse manual bow body. We hooked up the wiring to his factory wiring, which is pin 4. You run pin 4 off the middle wire of the neutral switch. There's the cable. I had to use the same starter that I did on the Frostbite truck, because this truck has headers and the headers get in the way. In order for this starter to fit, you have to grind just a little bit off the block for it to fit. It was not a big deal. We also studded it top and bottom. The inspection cover fits. The factory inspection cover fits on a 727 small block with some slight grinding right here to clear the starter. We used a factory transmission cooler and the cooling lines. And then here, let's see if I can get up on it. I have these unions that go from steel line to braided line and then run the braided line all the way around to the other side. So the installation for this swap was pretty easy. The modifications were the crossmember. Was the transmission mount to the original crossmember and mount, and the drive shaft. We used the Hemi flex plate. Everything else just was a bolt-in deal. It went pretty easy. That's my speedometer block off. You don't have to run the speedometer out of the transmission, because on these trucks the speedometer is run off the differential, and it's called a vehicle speed sensor. So we just put a plug in there to block that off. Speedometer is not needed. But the job went real good. We'll lit this down. And let's go on a test drive and see how she works. Leave me no bottles. Now, I left the nitrous disconnected and didn't give me no bottles. You think I was gonna blow it up on him? It is a top secret truck. 727 reverse manual valve body, billet steel drum, drag sprag, deep pan racing clutches, ready to go racing. There's our 545 FRE to 727 swap. You get, gentlemen, got any questions? You can email me at coperacingtrans@aol.com. You can leave your comment below, or you can go to the website at coperacingtrans.com. We got all the late model Gen 3 Hemi transmissions there, including Gen 2 Hemis, 440s, anything Mopar, we got it. So, thank you for watching, and Mopar to you. Bye.